DevOps, a combination of culture, practices, and tools to rapidly build and run software. DevOps first appeared around 2007 during an O'Reilly conference talk and was coined by the frustrated agile practitioner Patrick D. Boyce in 2009, who was unsatisfied with how software was built back then. Developers would spend days and nights writing thousands of lines of complex code for months. When they had finally finished their tasks, they handed the software over to the Q&A and operations teams for building, testing, deploying, and monitoring. Once bugs and errors appeared in the live systems, someone from the operations team had to figure out what went wrong and find someone from the developer team to have it fixed. This separation of development and operations into silos, also known as the waterfall model, was widely accepted but turned out to be not very efficient. Instead of long release cycles, DevOps focuses on rapid software delivery, collaboration and communication between key players by automating workflows as much as possible. While DevOps was initially meant to be a cultural shift, it is often reduced to its workflows and tools in today's world. The backbone of a DevOps workflow is CI/CD, continuous integration and continuous delivery. Continuous integration describes a practice where developers commit their code changes to a shared repository as often as possible, triggering automated processes for building and testing. Continuous delivery extends CI by adding an automated deployment step to the workflow. While 20 years ago, which is like 1,000 years in tech, software was released every 3 to 6 months at best, it's common for today's internet giants like Netflix to deploy several hundred times a day to production. When people talk about DevOps, terms like Docker, Kubernetes, and infrastructure as code are mentioned regularly. Docker lets you bundle your application into containers that can be deployed and run in any environment. Kubernetes is an open source container orchestration and management system developed at Google that is useful for running hundreds and thousands of containers. The last important concept of the DevOps world you should know is infrastructure as code. Instead of manually managing infrastructure components like networks or servers, DevOps engineers write machine-readable definition files to automatically provision resources. These files can be stored in repositories, leveraging all the benefits like versioning and CI/CD workflows. This was DevOps in a nutshell. Hit that subscribe button if you want to see more content like this.